The screen is visible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Nothing is there in this topic, but we already use all those things we are discussing in the theory of. So algebra of constant coefficient operators. There should be constant coefficient operators. We have used annihilator method. Now we are going to study the algebra of constant coefficient operators. Your equations may have this form: a naught, yz derivative, a one, yz minus one derivative, a two, yz minus two derivative, and so on, n y. This is going to equal to b of x. This a naught has to be non-zero to get its order as n. Further, we can divide by this a naught and rearranging new constants so that y to the yz derivative coefficient will become one. So from this, you to get order n, you must have the a naught is non-zero, and a one, a two, a n are the constants. All are the constants. Even a naught is also constant. These are constants. The size solution of this differential equation, size solution means it has particular solution as well as complementary solution. You can write psi nth derivative like this. How the size nth derivative is like this. X minus, I am putting in place of y psi and writing size nth derivative directly. B of x minus a1 upon a0 size n minus 1th derivative minus a2 upon a0 as n minus 2 derivative and so on minus an upon a naught size. Okay, this is size. The paper statement is like, let's try again. Then b of x is the continuous on your range. Minus infinity, less than x, less than infinity. Likewise, this size also exists on the same range, whatever size you have written. Now, here we are going to operator form. We are going to write this in operator form. All the operators, whatever operators we are defining, all the operators we assume they between valid for this range. That means it is a real number. I write two operators, suppose L of phi, a naught, phi is n derivative, a1. So this one differential equation, constant coefficients a naught, an, phi is n minus 1, and so on, an, phi. Whatever L is operator, phi, y, whatever you are taking, that thing will be goes for your phi or y. Another operator, M you have taken, for example, this is M of, can write this as b naught in phi you are writing b naught phi is n derivative b1 phi is n minus 1 the derivative and so on bn phi. Manje kai, you are definitely here is a differential equation a naught y is n derivative a1 y is n minus 1 derivative and a y. Similarly, these two are the differential operators. These two are differential operators. You can calculate L of anything. So there L of phi is written. So this a naught a1 a2 b naught b1 and this bn all are the constants. As we are discussing the linear equations with constant coefficients, the next unit we are going to discuss linear equation with variable coefficient. So corresponding to this, you can obtain one characteristic polynomial p of r, and corresponding to this will get another characteristic polynomial q of r. You can write a naught, what characteristic equation you get from here, a naught r to the power n plus a1 r to the power n minus 1 and so on an. And this q are equal to b0 r to the power n plus b1 r to the power n minus 1 and so on bn. So these two are the characteristic polynomial from that. It is not necessary to have these two equations, these two operators have same. The book here it is n is used and here one can use m also. So for understanding we use instead of n, we'll write m here. So the degree will be m, like that. Okay. It's not necessary that l and m should have same order. So now these L and N operators, the algebra you are going to define is that. Algebra means you can do their addition. Once you do addition, you can do subtractions. You can do their multiplication and you can multiply by the scalars. So this is the algebra of the constant coefficient operators. What operators? Your real operator we are given. Je kai differential equation hai. Udaharanarth mi lito L of Y apla equation hai. A naught, I am writing A naught every A naught. You can remove that A naught by dividing it, okay. N derivative a1 yn minus 1 the derivative and so on an y. So these are the derivative. This L can be written as a0 dn the derivative. What is d stands for? D stands for d by dx. So d1 stands for d by dx, d square stands for d2 by dx square, like that. Dn stands for dn's derivative with respect to n, with respect to x n time. So the operator. Right equality here, this is an operator a1 dn minus 1 derivative, like that. An d 0 derivative means y. This 0 derivative means you are writing y function itself, y or phi, whatever you are going to write. So this is algebra. L plus m, L into m and alpha into m. That algebra already used in the example. So how this L plus m is defined? L plus m of phi is L of phi plus m of phi. You either write y or anything. How this lm this has been applied in the annihilator method. L of m of phi, like this you can do. And alpha is a constant and multiplied to L operator. This is defined as alpha L of phi. That's it. Alpha is just constant multiplied to that. So these three things for alpha constant. This is your algebra of constant coefficient operators. Now, when two operators will be equal, just guess. When two operators will be equal? When L is equal to M. Can you repeat tell? Hey, L and M, tumcha mathe kema sarke astil? L puna ekda litu ya tikani mi. L is your A naught. L of phi is and m is a naught phi is m the derivative a1 phi is m minus 1 the derivative and so on am phi. He don sarke kya asil, just guess it. When these two operators are same, first of all their order has to be equal, and next thing, so whatever coefficients you are going to write here, b, okay, I should write b here. Whatever coefficient you are going to write, that coefficient has to be same. For I equal to 0, 1, 2, m. If m and n are equal, m and n should be same. So two operators are equal if and only if their order is same. And once order is same, the corresponding coefficients also has to be equal. Again, I am saying in on the range of the x, the real number. Whatever you are given to you. So equivalently at last of this section, it is mentioned that you can write L as n the derivative. Okay, I have written this already, L and value m. A naught n derivative, n minus 1 derivative multiplied by a1 and so on, a n last term. A n d the 0 derivative means y itself. M is a b1, d is m the derivative and so on, you can write. I have written above. Is L and M in terms of derivative operator. This one. This L, similarly, M you should write. B naught D M dm minus 1 and so on dm. This zero derivative means 1 itself. You can write instead of this, you get it to write 1. Multiply by 1. Now we'll have one theorem from this section that will conclude your second. The correspondence which associate with everybody mark attendance by writing the statement with each L equal to A naught Dn plus A1 Dn minus 1 plus and so on of An. Its characteristic polynomial P. Its characteristic polynomial P. Characteristic polynomial P will be given by this a naught r to the power n plus a1 r to the power n minus 1 and so on. So there is one to one correspondence of the equation. So is 1 to 1. Is one to one correspondence between all linear differential operators. All linear differential operators, all linear differential operators with constant coefficients, and all polynomials, म्हणजे प्रत्येक पॉलिनॉमियल घेतलं तुम्ही विथ कॉन्स्टंट कोएफिशिएंट्स तर त्याला असोसिएटेड तुम्ही एक लिनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन लिहू शकता आणि प्रत्येक लिनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशनला असोसिएटेड तुम्हाला एक पॉलिनॉमियल आहे. असं एकही डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन नाही की ज्याला कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल नाही किंवा असं एकही पॉलिनॉमियल नाही की जे कुणाचं ना कुणाचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल असणार नाही. त्यालाच म्हणायचं वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डन्स, म्हणजे एका संचमध्ये तुम्ही सगळे पॉलिनॉमियल्स टाका, त्याचे कोएफिशिएंट कॉन्स्टंट आहे इज रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑर्डर्स, आणि एका सेटमध्ये तुम्ही फक्त काय करा सगळे असे एल ऑपरेटर्स कलेक्ट करा ज्याचे कोएफिशिएंट काय असतील कॉन्स्टंट असतील. त्याच्यामध्ये वन वन करस्पॉन्ड असतो म्हणजे काय, द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट विल बी द सेम इन द बोथ सेट, वन पॉलिनॉमियल करस्पॉन्ड टू वन ओनली वन डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, इट विल नॉट करस्पॉन्डिंग टू टू डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन दॅट हॅव बीन डिफाइन्ड इन द इक्वालिटी ऑफ डेफिनेशन. बिसाइड दिस इफ एल कॉमा एम आर असोसिएटेड with P and Q, then L plus M is associated with which polynomial? You can guess. It is with P plus Q. M into L is associated with L is associated with P and alpha L is associated with alpha into P with this correspondence. पहिल्या स्टेटमेंटचा अर्थ समजून घ्या ठिकाणी. इन द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट व्हॉट वी हैव टू शो दैट देयर इज वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डन्स बिटवीन द वन सेट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ All L operators, irrespective of order. One set consists of all polynomials, set of all polynomials. So what it tells us that, so corresponding to every linear differential equation with constant coefficients, there is a polynomial, and it is. तुम्हाला एक function define करायचं आणि ते function काय define करणार, इथले L operator घेतलं तर त्याचं L operator म्हणजे काय असेल, त्याचं characteristic polynomial. बरोबर, त्या प्रत्येक L operator ला characteristic polynomial associate आहे. हे झालं वन वन. ऑन टू म्हणजे काय करायचं, इथल्या प्रत्येक पॉलिनॉमियल, कॉल समजा उदाहरणार्थ तुम्ही आर प्लस वन लिहिलं तर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन काय येईल, डीवाय बाय डी एक्स प्लस वन वाय असं येईल. म्हणजे इथला प्रत्येक कोणताही पॉलिनॉमियल घ्या तुम्ही, इन जनरल एनी पॉलिनॉमियल, ए नॉट आर एस टू के प्लस ए वन आर एस टू के मायनस वन अँड सो ऑन, डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विल करस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस विल बी दिस. ऍडमिट करा समजा हे दोन संच आहेत, एका सेटमध्ये सेट ऑफ ऑल लिनियर डिफरेन्शियल इक्वेशन ऑपरेटर आणि एका सेटमध्ये पॉलिनॉमियल. तर कोणताही लिनियर डिफरेन्शियल इक्वेशन घेतलं तर त्याला असोसिएटेड कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल असं आपण पाहिलेलं आहे कंपल्सरी. एका डिफरेन्शियल इक्वेशनला दोन पॉलिनॉमियल येत नाहीत, एका डिफरेन्शियल इक्वेशनला एकच पॉलिनॉमियल येतं. आणि को डोमेनमध्ये कोणताही पॉलिनॉमियल घ्या त्याच्याशी करस्पॉन्डिंग तुम्ही, आता हे पॉलिनॉमियल विथ कॉन्स्टंट कोएफिशिएंट, लिनियर डिफरेन्शियल ऑपरेटर विथ कॉन्स्टंट कोएफिशिएंट, ट्रिवली देअर इज वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डिंग. आपण काय म्हणू की वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डन्स कॅन बी होल्ड दिस एल इक्वल टू एम, दिस एल इक्वल टू एम इफ अँड ओनली इफ पी इक्वल टू क्यू. आता एलला असोसिएटेड कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल पी असेल, एमला असोसिएटेड कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल पी असेल, ज्यावेळेस एल आणि एम सारखे आहेत म्हणजे काय, एलचे कोएफिशिएंट आणि एमचे कोएफिशिएंट आणि ऑर्डर सारखी, तर तसंच पीचे ऑर्डर आणि क्यूची डिग्री, पी आणि क्यूची डिग्री सारखी असेल, आणि हेच कोएफिशिएंट सारखे म्हणलं हे पी आणि क्यू सारखे असेल. त्या एका स्टेटमेंटमुळे वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डन्स येऊन जातात. द वन टू वन करस्पॉन्डन्स इज बिकॉज ऑफ एल इक्वल टू एम इफ अँड ओनली पी इक्वल टू क्यू. आता बाकीचा थिरम आपल्याला प्रूव्ह करायचं, समजा आता काय करू आपण, एल प्लस एम याचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल काढायचं आपल्याला. एलचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल पी ऑफ आर दिलेलं आहे आणि एमचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल काय दिलेलं आहे, क्यू ऑफ आर. तर आपण कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल काढताना आपण फाय काय घेतो, ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स घेतो, याच्यावर तुम्हाला पॉलिनॉमियल इन आर मिळते. L of e to the power rx plus m of e to the power rx. हा कोण आहे, पी ऑफ आर e to the power rx आपण पाहिलेले. दिस इज एल ऑपरेटर e to the power rx वरती ऑपरेट केला तर पॉलिनॉमियल इन आर इंटू ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स येतं. तसंच एम ला पण काय येईल, एमचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल क्यू ऑफ आर दिलेलं आहे, ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स. म्हणजे काय आलं, पी ऑफ आर प्लस क्यू ऑफ आर इंटू ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स. So, P of R, Q of R is characteristic polynomial of this L, L plus L. Similarly, go for this, e to the power Rx. So, L of M of e to the power Rx. So, L of M of e to the power Rx is Q of R into e to the power Rx. Now, this Q of R is independent of that X, so it will be treated as constant. So Q of R into L of e to the power Rx. What is L of e to the power Rx? Anybody guess? Any guess? What is L of e to the power Rx? L of e to the power Rx is the characteristic polynomial of L into e to the power Rx. If you go in the previous lectures of characteristic polynomial, there you will come to know why you are writing this e to the power Rx. ज्यावेळेस एखादा ऑपरेटर तुम्ही अप्लाय करता एक्सपोनेन्शियल ऑफ आर एक्स वरती, एक्सपेरियन्शियल ऑफ आर एक्स इन टू पॉलिनॉमियल इन टर्म्स ऑफ आर ए, तर हे असतं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल. सो दिस इज द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल ऑफ एल एम. ऍट लास्ट अल्फा टाइम्स एल याचं कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक पॉलिनॉमियल काढायचं मला, ते पुन्हा ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स वरती अप्लाय करा. सो अल्फा हा कॉन्स्टंट आहे, ई टू द पॉवर आर एक्स असं येईल या प्रकारे. अल्फा L of e to the power rx is p of r into e to the power rx. So alpha p of e to the power rx. So alpha p is characteristic polynomial of alpha l. Alpha p is the characteristic polynomial of alpha l. Do you get? Just write the theorem statement.